So it's quite a romp. I enjoy it.
Yeah, because you weren't typecast, because you went into something completely different. I mean, the professionals.
The professionals, yes.
You're very tough. Did you have to... You had to do a bit of acting there, because you're not a tough chap like that. Cowley's
a
very
tough man.
Yeah,
well, I suppose it was my army sergeant part coming back again, but I found it very difficult coping with the boys, Doyle and Bodie, because before, you see, I'd say to Ruby and Jean, do this, do that, Rose, do... And they did.
Right.
And suddenly I said, do this, do that to them, and they looked the other way and scratched their heads, and I thought, where is the authority gone? You know what I mean? So eventually I decided, when in doubt, shout.
This is a foul-up. But I'm here, and under arrest, I presume,
of the house variety, George. We'd like you to report in here every day for...
For questioning.
Just for a little chat.
I see. And you need my passport, too?
No. We already have it. But I'm sorry, George.
Yes, Tully, I know. I made the rules.
It's just a formality, George.
Oh, come on, Manton. You know as well as I do that mud sticks, the mud of association. If we could have had Drake alone, kept him under wraps for a week or two...
It's not to be.
Too bloody right. If Drake isn't delivered properly, then I can look forward to remaining mud-splattered for the rest of my life.
What about yourself? I mean, when you're not learning your lines and sort of cocooned, what sort of hobbies you got?
I love music. I'm passionately fond of music, especially Mozart. I absolutely worship Mozart.
I mean, can you play?
I do, yes. I've just treated myself to a new piano again. I used to play a lot when I was about... in my teens and late teens, and then my sons were born. It was a case of, the children are sleeping, sort of thing. I never played for years. And then suddenly, now that the boys have gone, and they've gone to their individual flats, sort of thing, I suddenly thought, I'd take it up again. And I thought, why not treat yourself in the twilight of life to a decent piece?
Twilight of life, go on,
come on,
young
chap. Of course. And I got me a Steinway, and I'm having great fun making masses of mistakes. I don't bore my friends with it,
no. But
I just love it. I love music.
You got the OBE, didn't you, just in the late 70s?
No one more surprised than I was. I thought it was marvellous, marvellous.
Well, it's an accolade, isn't it? And
I was
nice
absolutely thrilled, and it's the best show in town, because it's so beautifully stage-managed with all the guardsmen standing. It's so magnificent, the palace and Her Majesty coming out, and the beef-eaters all around it. I thought it was absolutely breathtaking, and the word I got of it was very extraordinary, because I was out in Kenya at the time, and Government House rang me up to say, I want to see you. I said, look, I'm leaving tomorrow, I'm packing. He said, it's very important, we've just had communication from Downing Street. And my boys at that time, this is a few years ago, were at Westminster School, which was just beside the Houses of Parliament, and I was convinced. I said, yes, they've set fire to the Houses of Parliament, and this man is coming to tell me that they're both in the tower. So when eventually he did come and said, I'm happy to tell you the Prime Minister has put your name forward to Her Majesty, and if she approves you, would you accept the OBE? It was a relief. It wasn't joy. It was a relief.
Oh, just that. Oh, yes.
Yes. Thank heavens, the boys
have. If a chap who says he doesn't like acting, which is your profession, you look remarkably happy and composed.
Oh, it's a cry for help. We all have a different ways of covering up. That's why I adore actors. All my friends are actors. Mm. And we have different ways. You get temperamental actors, but you understand that's their way of covering up. The basic fear. Although dear Angela used to say, Angela Badley, when she woke up in the morning of recordings of Upstairs Down, she said, isn't it wonderful we're going to record it today? I woke up that morning and thought, I go to the executioner's block today, I couldn't get out of bed. It's amazing, amazing different attitudes.
But no real regrets?
Oh no, because I've met such marvellous people on the way, and I've seen some marvellous places, and it's much better than working down the coal mine, let's face it, it's a fantastic... Well,
carry on for another 20 years or so, will you?
Well, who knows, they say that Finlay Curry, when he came off a plane from New York at 94 he was, he said, what have you been up to, Finlay? He said, I've just been recording Brigadoon, it should do me a lot of good. Now that's the attitude, I like that.
Well, you've got it, and I wish you a very happy future.
Thank you very much, Mark. Thank you.